Hello and welcome. Today we have for you a new video on how to remove the FRP lock on Samsung S7 Edge. And this method works perfectly on Samsung devices that run Android version 6. So as you can see, after you connect the phone to the internet, it will ask you to enter the old Google account that was synced before. So to fix that, start by putting a SIM card before doing this. Then connect the phone with the USB cable to the computer and make sure to install the correct drivers. Download and install the application Realtor. The link will be in the description down below. Now go to the device manager and look for the modem port. It should be listed under modem. For us it was 38. Now go back to the Realtor application and in the port tab switch the port. Then press change, then open. You should see three lights on the right side. Now go to the send tab and type the first command, which is at+creg to register the SIM card on the network. And when you are done, press send. It should say OK. Now for the second command, type ATD198, which is an AT command, and the D198 part is to dial the number 198. Then press send again. Now go back to the phone and hangs up quickly, then press message. From there type google.com, then send it. Then click on that link. It will open it in Samsung browser, so you need to switch to the Chrome application. Now search for the Google Account Manager 6.0.1 because we have Android 6.0.1. Choose any website and download the APK. Yeah, by the way, Chrome might need some permission, so just allow it. Okay, when the download is completed, open the APK. Before installing it, you have to allow the install from unknown sources. Now after finishing the install, go back to Chrome and look for Quick Shortcut Maker application. I usually go to up to down website because it doesn't have any annoying pop-ups ad. When the download complete, open the APK and install it. This time it will not ask you for a permission because you already enabled it. Okay, after you open it, look for the application Google Account Manager. Then choose the event with the first, type email and password. Click on it, then press try. From the top, press the option button and choose browser sign in. Now enter any working Gmail account. After you are done connecting your account to the phone, go all the way back to the Wi-Fi screen, then press next. It should say account added, like this. If it doesn't, then you have messed up somewhere and you need to go back and check. Now just follow the usual setup instruction the same way you set up a new device. And that's it. Now your phone is unlocked and you can use it normally. If this tutorial helped you unlock your phone, please leave a thumbs up and consider subscribing. Thank you for watching and see you next time.